Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to dive deep into an intriguing nail health mystery. What causes those vertical ridges on your nails? If you look down at your nails right now, you might notice small lined grooves running from the cuticle to the tip of your nails. These are totally normal, especially as we age. But sometimes those small grooves can turn into large, prominent ridges. This abnormal change in nail texture often signals that something is off inside the body. But what exactly is the root cause? That's what we are going to uncover today. Now, some of you may be thinking, come on, they are just little ridges on my nails. It's not a big deal. But stay with me here, because the nails provide major insight into our health. The nails are intricately connected to other parts of the body through nerves, blood vessels, and bone marrow. So when our bodies are struggling to function properly, the nails are often the first place to show warning signs. Those odd changes in texture, color, or shape indicate nutritional deficiencies or hormonal imbalances. And if we ignore the early subtle messages from our nails, eventually, much larger problems can develop. So let's dive in and explore the top reasons why prominent vertical ridges may be appearing on your nails. As we go through each one, think about which cause relates most to you and your lifestyle. This will help you identify the source so you can take action to fix it. Reason number one, iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia is the most common nutritional disorder in the world. It's estimated that 1.62 billion people suffer from lack of iron. Now, iron is required to produce hemoglobin, the protein in red blood cells that binds to oxygen. When we don't have enough iron, our blood cells cannot carry sufficient oxygen to the nails, skin, and other tissues. Over time, this impaired oxygen delivery causes the nail bed tissue to shrink and compress. And that compression is what leads to the deep vertical grooves. In addition to ridged nails, symptoms of iron deficiency include headaches, fatigue, pale skin, restless legs, and shortness of breath. Many women lose considerable iron during their monthly menstruation. Frequent blood donors are also at risk. And people who follow plant-based diets may not be consuming enough iron-rich foods. To boost your iron levels, eat more grass-fed beef, oysters, lentils, spinach, and pumpkin seeds. Consider taking an iron supplement or getting an infusion if your stores are depleted. Reason number two, vitamin B12 deficiency. Now let's move on to another key nutrient connected to oxygen circulation and nail health, vitamin B12. B12 plays several crucial roles in the body. It helps form red blood cells, maintain nerve function, and synthesize DNA. When B12 levels run low, the nerves become damaged. This prevents proper neurological signaling to the nail matrix where growth originates. And like with iron deficiency, poor nerve conduction reduces blood flow and oxygen delivery to the nail bed tissue. The end result, pronounced vertical nail ridges. Vegans and vegetarians are especially prone to B12 deficiency since it's found primarily in animal foods. Other risks include celiac disease, Crohn's disease, medications, and pernicious anemia, an autoimmune condition that destroys intrinsic factor needed to absorb B12. Supplementing with a B12 methylcobalamin supplement is vital for anyone at risk of deficiency. Also consider eating B12 fortified nutritional yeast, chlorella, and kombucha. All right, now that we've covered the big two nutrient deficiencies, let's move on to a few other potential causes of vertical nail ridges. As we go through the next set, think about how your lifestyle could be inadvertently contributing to nail texture changes. Reason number three, thyroid dysfunction. Research shows that prominent longitudinal ridges are associated with hypothyroidism, otherwise known as an underactive thyroid. The thyroid gland controls our metabolism, temperature regulation, heart rate, and also nail growth. When thyroid hormones are low, the body can't function properly. Common symptoms of hypothyroidism include dry skin and hair, weight gain, muscle soreness, and fatigue. Changes in nail texture are also a typical sign. Hypothyroidism has several underlying causes: autoimmune disease, iodine deficiency, inflammation, certain medications. Blood work measuring TSH, T3 and T4 can confirm if thyroid dysfunction is the culprit behind your nail changes. Balancing the thyroid naturally involves de-stressing, limiting inflammatory foods, exercising, and possibly supplementing with iodine, selenium, zinc, and vitamin D, depending on lab results. Reason number 4, high stress levels. Chronic stress is yet another hidden factor that disrupts nail growth and leads to ridging. When we endure long-term stress and anxiety, our adrenal glands release high amounts of the hormone cortisol. And cortisol has many health consequences when it's pumped out above normal rhythms. Cortisol inhibits the body's use of key nail-healthy nutrients like biotin, zinc, and methionine. It impairs thyroid function and constricts blood vessels, reducing oxygen flow to the nail bed tissue. High cortisol also triggers oxidative damage and accelerates aging. The nails, being a visible body part made of fast-growing cells, are often one of the first places to demonstrate aging. If emotional stress feels out of control and nail ridges have appeared, it's vital to reset with relaxation techniques, adaptogenic herbs, positive thinking, and counseling. Reason number 5, poor digestion. Now, this next cause relates to nutrient absorption rather than intake. Even if we eat plenty of iron and B12-rich foods, if our digestion is weak, those nutrients won't be assimilated properly. Signs of poor digestion include acid reflux, bloating, constipation, and irregular stools. These indicate impaired stomach acid production and enzymatic activity. And when we don't have adequate stomach acid and digestive enzymes, we cannot break down and assimilate minerals like iron and vitamins like B12. Improving digestion is key for reversing poor nail health. Strategies include chewing thoroughly, drinking raw apple cider vinegar, taking HCL supplements, and eating fermented pickles, yogurt, and kefir. Reason number 6, nail trauma from biting. Okay, lastly, let's touch on physical nail and cuticle damage. Consistent nail biting and picking can harm the nail matrix and alter nail texture. When we bite and rip off the cuticle, it tears the protective sealing layer that protects the nail growth center. This allows bacteria and viruses to enter, causing inflammation. The pressure of biting can also traumatize the nerves under the nails. And as we've learned, nerve issues affect circulation to the nail bed tissue, which can lead to changes like ridging. Kicking the nail biting habit requires being aware of triggers like stress and replacing it with a relaxing activity. Bandages and anti-bitter polish can also help deter biting behavior. All right, we just covered the 6 most common factors that cause abnormal vertical ridging of the nails: iron and B12 deficiency, thyroid dysfunction, high cortisol, poor digestion, and nail biting. Hopefully, you now have a good idea which of these potential causes could be contributing to your own nail ridges. While the ridges may seem harmless on the surface, they signify deeper imbalances are brewing. And if ignored over time, far more concerning health issues can develop. Luckily, paying attention to our nail signals and making appropriate nutrition and lifestyle adjustments can help restore proper nail growth and texture. Your nails are like the canary in the coal mine, an early indicator of potential dysfunction in the body. So respect their messages and take care of your whole self. All right, that sums up this nail health mystery investigation. Let me know in the comments which reason you think might be behind your vertical ridges. And if you learned something new today, don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.